الصلاة is your معراج. This is your ascension to heavens. لأن الصلاة the pillar of the deen. الصلاة is the communication between the slave and his lord. And therefore those who want to go through the maqamat and the ranks of the salik, and those people who want to go to Allah, إلى الله, those who want to do salook to Allah, what happens to the salah? As-salah is dhikr. Allah mentions it. He says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَأَقِيمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. Salah dhikr. Not only that, as-salah takes you from the maqam of dhikr to the maqam of khushu'. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Khushu', salah, dhikr, maqam of khushu', all the way until you are at the maqam of qurb to Allah. As-salah itself. I'm saying this because oftentimes we want to look for everything else while it's right in front of us. As-salah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Kalla la tuti'hu wasjud waqtarib. Wasjud waqtarib. Have sujood and have qurb. Those to Allah, there's your salah. That's why كان النبي صلى الله عليه وآله والحديث الصحيح. He says, حبب إلي من دنياكم, to from your dunya three things, or he did not say three, by the way, this is مدرج, not in the hadith. Again, from your dunya things were beloved to me. He says, أطيب ونساء, and he says, وجعلت قرة عيني في الصلاة. The oasis, the coolness of my eyes in the dunya is in the salah. The last thing I'll mention, and I promise that will be in this Isra and Miraj, I want to just touch really base quickly on this, is Maqam al-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa Allah. Because we are invited by our Naqshbandiya brothers, and we are all Naqshbandis in that sense. And as you all know, one way of the silsila Naqshbandiya al-Aliyya qaddas Allahu sirra asrari hamadiyya go through Sayyidina Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu wa Allah to Sayyidina Salman al-Faris radiyallahu alayhima. And mawqif al-Siddiq, in life, how do you judge people? By how much money they have? People are like principles. You are a principle. Your money will go away. Like in your principle where you stand, your word, the principles that make you, this is who you are. Huh? You cannot go to the market and say, I would like to buy $5 worth of akhlaq. There's no such thing. Or please, can you give me £1 worth of sidq? I would like to buy £3 worth of amana. £1 worth of ikhlas. لكن you find الأمانة والإخلاص والصدق والتسليم والإسلام in people. And therefore, I'm not looking today at the biggest قشوة, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, لكن I would like to look at a man who صنعه محمد Rasulullah. He was folded and molded by Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. He was fed and nourished the nur of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. That was Abu Bakr Siddiq رضي الله تعالى. And therefore, hadith, and you all know the hadith has authentic, isn't it? Where Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم says, I never offered Islam to anybody, but they hesitated, except Abu Bakr. When I told him, Aslam, Ya Abu Bakr, Aslam, what did Abu Bakr say? قال أسلمت لرب العالمين. I became Muslim. This is a character of the Anbiya, by the way. Aslam, Aslam. Huh? Surah Al-Baqarah. Huh? Allah talks about Ibrahim. وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِهَ نَفْسَهُ وَلَقَدِ اصْطَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Ibrahim was among those who are chosen in dunya, and in the akhirah he's among the salihin. What is going on, Ya Allah? إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. His Lord told him, become Muslim. Ibrahim said, أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for me and you that Siddiqi approach to Islam. Amen. So that we can change our life into a Siddiqi way of life. Amen. So we have Siddiq and Tasdeeq. So we can become among those whom Allah blessed with Siddiqiyya in this dunya and the akhirah. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله. السلام عليكم.
تكبير.
Based on sajda to the words of to the words of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, brother, and also this one is in Urdu, so I will ask inshallah, brother Yamani.
I have a question regarding Asar e Mubarak. There is some people do
bosa,
kissing, and sajda to the parts of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the body parts like hair and nails. Is this jais? Could you quote a hadith regarding this?
Allah says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. So that's the ta'zim, whoever does ta'zim, glorification of the sha'air of Allah, this is from the taqwa. And obviously that's, we're talking about the Safa and Marwa and Sa'i. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi is a'zam, is more bigger and more greater than all these things. So kissing and all these things is jaiz. With sajda, obviously, even sujood of tahiyyah, ta'zim, that is not spoken about in a sense in the permissibility in our sharia, though it does not constitute shirk. Yani, even if someone does sujood of tahiyyah that is not accompanied with worship, that is not shirk, because as you all know from Quran al-Kareem, the parents of you, Ya'qub alayhi salam, wa kharru lahu sujjada. If it's shirk, do the Anbiya commit shirk? Does Allah teach us in the Quran shirk? Lakin sujood, we don't do sujood, lakin we do kissing. Kissing, what do you mean kissing? You kiss the sand that the shoes of Rasulullah walk on, not part of him sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Because anything he touched has barakah and has shifa and has nur. So Sayyidina Imam Malik ibn Anas, Imam al-Madhab, the Imam of the Madhab, when he used to go to Medina, he would not wear his shoes in Medina. In Tayyiba Tayyiba, why? Because he says, I'm afraid that I would put my shoes on a place where the feet of Rasulullah touched. So ta'zeem al-Mustafa and janab al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is wajib. But this is actually alama of iman. And those who do ta'zeem, and ta'zeem by kissing and glorifying and seeking its barakah, and asking Allah to assemble you with it, etc., that all jaiz. But mustahab, but wajib fil mu'mineen, but fard ala muhib. To the people of mahabba, this is fard. Subhanallah. But the people of not mahabba, that's a different story.
MashaAllah. And this question is, why are jibnikilat, or the border nights, the nights of Laylat al-Mi'raj and the Ra'ah and Laylat al-Qadr, considered as bid'ah? Are there any rules to back it up? I mean, waking up or staying in ibadah and the nights, slow nights.
Akhi, in order for you to say it's haram or not permissible, there has to be dalil. Dalil means evidence. Evidence is from two things: book and authentic sunnah. I don't see any ayah in the Quran and any hadith that says you cannot stay up any night of the week. Allah says, in fact, the Quran Kareem, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Do the good so you may succeed. In general, be اطلاق, you do the good. So there's no restriction on doing any ibadah as long as you are doing As-salah, zakah, and salawat of the Prophet ﷺ, and dhikr, and gathering people around us, and feeding them, and talking about the seerah of the Nabi ﷺ. This is all not only jaiz, but mustahab as well.